Dear class of 2020, this was our year. Our last year to make one last memorable memory. Our last few months of senior year might not have gone the way we wanted it. We may not have a prom, our senior trip, graduation, or have that one last walk throughout our elementary schools and high school. Seeing all those teachers who have helped us get to where we are at this very moment. Before this begins, I'd like to thank those of you who have cooperated to help me. You might see some new yet old faces, but they are still part of our class. Here I light up a candle to represent hope, to pass among my friends, to let everyone know that even in dark times, there will always be light.
Can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, you wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me.
Please stay safe, and remember, we are all in this together. Thank you.
Good evening, and welcome to the Bogota Junior Senior High School Commencement Exercise of 2020. Graduates Laura Pena and Natalie Hardwick will now lead us in the flag salute, followed by Gabrielle Cintron singing the national anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Allow me to introduce and thank those who made today possible. Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Damian Kennedy, our Business Administrator, Mr. Irfan Efsel, President of the Bogota Board of Education, Ms. Lisa Coles, Board of Education Vice President, Ms. Amanda Montgomery, Trustees, Ms. Eileen Lewis, Ms. Idalia Alvarez, Ms. Sabrina Kearns, Mr. Pat McHale, Mr. Jim Moore, Ms. Maureen Miller, and Ms. Kathy Van Buren. We also have Vice Principal Dr. Eric Alfonso, Supervisor of Student Services, Ms. Jill Connolly, Director of Research and Planning, Mr. Sam Chang, Bixby Principal, Mr. Damon Inglis, Steen Principal, Ms. Dale Santora. I would also like to recognize our senior class advisors, Ms. Joan Fry and Ms. Joanne Herboski, who put in more hours than they ever could have imagined, putting together a truly meaningful end of the year for the class of 2020. Valedictorian, Ms. Natalie Hardwick, salutatorian, Ms. Lara Pena, and myself, Principal Kelly Foley, Deacon Giglio. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our guests who so graciously support us. This includes the Honorable Mayor Chris Kellerman and Bogota Town Council members, and the many faculty and staff who have tuned in tonight to share in this great accomplishment with our graduates. I would also like to personally thank our secretaries who helped make all this possible. Additionally, I would like to thank others who honor us with their presence and provided support throughout the years. Chief May in the Bogota Police Department, Bogota Fire Department, Mr. Jim Moore in the Recreation Department, our PTO Executive Board members, Alexandra Pica Cabrera, Doreen Lechuga, Jose Chavez, and Beth Cabrera, and all members of the Parent Teacher Organization. I also want to extend a special welcome to your family and friends and thank them for their support that they have provided to us over the lifetime of these very special graduates. The town of Bogota was officially founded in 1894 and opened the doors of the high school in 1924. A lot has changed, but the heart of these students has not. Today, this makes you the 93rd graduating class, and I'm so proud to recognize and be a part of this rich heritage and to add 77 new graduates to the thousands who have graduated before them. We bid them farewell with the certainty that they will continue to represent Bogota High School with an increased pride in themselves and their roots. I now invite our Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Damian Kennedy, to say a few words.
Good evening. For members of the class of 2020, today marks the end of your journey through Bogota Public Schools. Much has been accomplished along the way. Much has been learned through experiences, both in and out of the classroom. This year has been truly unique and something that you will never forget. But what is important is that you were able to make adjustments and adapt to your new reality. Being able to do that will help you be successful in life. I had the opportunity of watching you grow from uncertain and nervous seventh graders to confident men and women ready to take on the world. But before you do that, I would like to share a poem with you that I keep in my office, titled The Bottom Line, whose author is anonymous. Face it, nobody owes you a living. What you achieve or fail to achieve in your lifetime is directly related to what you do or fail to do. No one chooses his parents or childhood, but you can choose your own direction. Everyone has problems and obstacles to overcome, but that too is relative to each individual. Nothing is carved in stone. You can change anything in your life if you want to badly enough. Excuses are for losers. Those who take responsibility for their actions are real winners in life. Winners meet life's challenges head on, knowing there are no guarantees, and give it their all they got. And never think it's too late or too early to begin. Time plays no favorites and will pass whether you act or not. Take control of your life. Dare to dream and take risks. Compete. If you aren't willing to work for your goals, don't expect others to. Believe in yourself. Bogota, high school class of 2020, the bottom line is this, that whatever you choose to be in your life, be the best version that you can be. Good luck and never forget where you came from. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kennedy. Our salutatorian, Lara Pena, is a hardworking, ambitious, busy, and kind student with a very strong work ethic. She was an active member of the class of 2020, playing multiple roles in band and running cross country and track, as well as a volunteer in our community. Next year, she will attend Rutgers University with a major in journalism and media studies. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the class of 2020 salutatorian, Lara Pena.
Good evening, Bogota High School class of 2020, administrators, teachers, family, and friends. Thank you for attending our virtual graduation, and I'm very glad you could join us. I am honored to speak to you as the class's salutatorian. I never would have expected that we'd be graduating online, but there's always a first time for everything. The important thing to remember is that through our hard times, we need to empower each other so that we can make the world a better place. Everyone asks, what's your plan for the future? Why does the world ask this question to students who barely remember what they had for breakfast? As for me at this very moment, I can say that I want to go off to college and study journalism, though the path from here to there is uncertain. I'm sure everyone else has similar feelings toward the future. You can say you have a plan, but only time will tell if it'll actually play out that way. We are living in unpredictable times, but this is our new normal. This didn't turn out the way we planned, but this is a test of our strength, and we are adapting with grace. Even the people who look most put together are struggling to find their place. I can assure you that our parents and our teachers are also still trying to figure it out. We are all human. I want to thank our parents who have worked so hard to create better lives for themselves and their families. Like some of your parents, my parents are immigrants. They're from the Philippines, a small island country in Asia. My parents are some of the most hardworking people I know. They've taught me to value education like I value my life. They've always supported me throughout all of my days, good or bad. Because of them, I graduate today, ready to take on whatever comes next. And I can't thank them enough for everything they've done for me. Our teachers are also there for us, and they'll continue to be rooting for us after we graduate. We never could have done it without the support of our dedicated teachers at school. day in and day out. They are there earlier and later than us. We have formed our second families at Bogota High School with our faculty and friends. From after-school talks with Mr. McCann to cross-country practice with Coach Rockford, I am grateful for the support system this school has built for each and every one of us. Throughout high school, you might have been pushing forward for the people around you. We all have people who have supported us these last 4 years. This is our day and our day alone. It is, without a doubt, the day where we celebrate our accomplishments and achievements from our years of high school. With success also comes failure. We make mistakes that will push us to become better people. The whole reason behind this is that I hope we fail and fail forward. No one is ever spared from failure, and that is because through our hardships, we will be able to learn from our experiences. It is easy to say that we want to be at the top of whatever mountain we'd like to climb, whether that is to attend law or medical school, or to be at the top of our careers. But these mountains are the steepest in the world. We are now high school graduates as of this moment, and our mountains will only get steeper from here. Each one of us has our own mountains to climb. I encourage us to make and embrace the mistakes, because we will be stronger on the other side. We definitely got our firsts from Bogota High School. I never expected myself to run cross country, join the art club, or intern for my favorite teacher. It's true, our last times together were either not the way we planned them to be, or we didn't even have the chance to live them out. We may have been excited to show off at prom or award ceremonies, or create lasting memories of our last year of sports and events that we can look back fondly on. It is disappointing that we didn't experience the year that we expected, but we are resilient, and we will continue to persevere. This one bump in the road is just that. The rest of our exciting lives is waiting for us. If there's one thing I've learned from these last 4 years, it's what it means to be a Buccaneer. Our school, our home away from home, has taught me how to put in all of my efforts and be persistent with my goals. After today, we will keep the memories that we love close to our hearts, and soon enough, everything else will fade away. I hope the memories we've made together remind you of your best times in high school. While we all will be leading different lives from this point on, we will be connected by Bogota High School. Whether you aim to pursue further education, go into the workforce, or have other plans, I wish us all success and happiness that will last us for lifetimes. We are the protagonists of the world, and I am incredibly excited to watch everyone's stories blossom right in front of our eyes as we all grow and glow. Class of 2020, let's make a mental note to our future selves. We will make each other proud. Let's be so bright that we set the world ablaze. My fellow seniors, congratulations.
Thank you, Lara. The Bogota Junior Senior High School Band will now play a musical selection titled Bridge Over Troubled Water by Simon and Garfunkel.
Thank you, Mr. McCann and the Bogota Junior Senior High School Band. Tonight, we are honored to welcome our guest speaker. He is a man by his own admission that does not like to talk about himself. But he is a man everyone talks about here at Bogota Junior Senior High School. So before I introduce him, I will do the same. This alumni scored 2,546 points in his high school career. He was first team all-county 3 years in a row, first team all-state, and an American third team his senior year. And he was instrumental in leading his team to the county and state titles. He went on to play North Carolina University on a full ride and was a member of the 1993 North Carolina National Championship team. After graduating from North Carolina, this Buck accepted an assistant coaching position with North Carolina University. But he didn't stop there. He went on to be an assistant coach with the Detroit Pistons when they won the NBA title. He also coached with the Nets, Clippers, and Wizards before settling back in New York as an assistant coach of the New York Knicks. He is married with a daughter and stepson. When he attended Bogota High School, the principal at the time, Roy Corso, would always talk about how Pat was not only an all-time great basketball player, but an excellent student. He was in all honors and a member of the National Honor Society. He did it all, and tonight he showed up for the class of 2020. It gives me great pleasure to introduce our alumni, class of 1990, Mr. Patrick Sullivan.
Good evening and welcome to the Bogota High School graduation class of 2020. It has been 125 years since the first graduating class here at BHS, and it's been 30 years since I graduated from Bogota High. I would like to thank Principal DeCongelio, the faculty, staff, and Coach Sterling for contacting me about speaking. I would like to take this opportunity to salute and congratulate every student that represents the class of 2020. It's an honor to be invited to speak to you all at your graduation. It's hard for me to believe that I left Bogota High School 30 years ago. The memories and bonds I created there are still with me today. Being part of the basketball team was a life-changing experience for me and my teammates. Our group is hardworking, competitive, and unselfish. Coach Mahoney instilled those characteristics into our entire team. His relentless spirit and fight was second to none, and we were sure he'd be burned out from coaching soon after he graduated. Boy, were we wrong. And those of you that play for Coach Mahoney know what I mean. This is my first time speaking at a graduation, and I spent a lot of time researching what to talk about, and I gathered a lot of ideas, but most of the ideas centered on the experience of the speaker, and I'm really not comfortable speaking about myself, and I wanted to put the focus on all of you. Back in March, everything around us changed because of the coronavirus. The world we assumed that would welcome all of us graduates with open arms has changed in ways we can never imagine or prepare for. Some of us have experienced pain and loss during this global pandemic. Our economy has taken a huge hit, and you have all been forced into a new concept called remote learning. I would like to take this opportunity for everyone to acknowledge and commend your intellect, resilience, and especially your grit. We all have uncertainty and unanswered questions about the coronavirus, but I am confident and, quite frankly, looking forward to the response and leadership that will emerge from the class of 2020. You all will have a direct impact of how the world responds and grows as we move forward as a global community. That's a great responsibility, and it was given to you all for a reason. I too have had my life put on hold from COVID-19. As a basketball coach for the New York Knicks, our season has been suspended indefinitely. So I can feel some of your pain, but it's not even close to the pain you're feeling. Having the last 3 months of your senior year taken away is something I can't even wrap my head around. Not being able to go to prom or graduation is heartbreaking. Clearly, it's not just the ceremonial or official events of BHS that has been stolen from you. It's all the little moments and memories that have been wiped away. Like hanging out on spring nights with your friends, walking around BHS as if you own the school, and just enjoying your last few months of being a senior. That's what most people don't understand. It's not the big moments, it's all the little ones in between that can't be replaced. All of you have been forced to grow up very quickly over the last few months. Having feelings of anger, frustration, and disappointment is natural. And believe me, it's not selfish to ask why now or why is this happening to our class? Healing takes time, It's a process, and it may take some longer than others to move forward, and that's okay. What I want you to think about and remember is that you still have experienced enough great times. It's been an incredible 3¾ years at BHS, and that's what I want you to try to focus on. Even though none of you deserve to have your last year of high school end like this, you still have enough great memories to draw upon. Remember all the late nights spent studying or talking with friends, all the papers you wrote, the tests you took, the games and practices, the applause of the audience after a performance, working on the school newspaper, art projects, lunch in the cafeteria, passing in the halls, headed to class, meeting new classmates, or strengthening old friendships. This pandemic cannot take away the memories you have or the relationships that you have built. Your perspective on life will always be valued and viewed differently than any other class in over 100 years. The fact that you have gained a unique understanding of family and how important it is to love and protect your family are life lessons that you will always have. This class, more than any, will be remembered for innovation, strength, perseverance, and most of all, resiliency. As you move forward in life, appreciate your uniqueness, embrace your inner strength, and celebrate your ability to grow from adversity. Your parents, families, and teachers care about you and love you more than you know. They couldn't be more proud of you and how you have handled these uncertain times and challenges. This is our new normal, and each and every one of you has a story to write. You determine the narrative, and most importantly, you control your own destiny. Abraham Lincoln once said, and I loosely translate, "This too shall pass." When things are bad, remember, it won't always be this way. Take one day at a time. When things are good, remember, it won't always be this way. Enjoy every great moment. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan. This year's valedictorian, Natalie Hardwick, is hardworking, determined, and full of musical talent. She was born for great things. She is very active in our fine arts department and runs cross country and track. To be honest, anytime I'm driving through Bogota, I see her running. She is a leader with the ability to also be a team player, while carrying herself with dignity, confidence, and always a smile. In the fall, Natalie will be attending Rowan University with a major in exploratory studies. It is now my great pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2020, Natalie Hardwick.
Good evening, graduates, teachers, administration, family, friends, and everyone else joining us today. We are all very aware that we are not graduating under normal circumstances. Instead of speaking across the football field or the gym, I am staring at a camera lens. No one ever told me that speaking to inanimate objects was a necessary life skill. So yes, this is most definitely not how we expected our senior year to go. But it doesn't matter. We did miss out on a lot of the memories we wanted to make, but we are making new ones just the same. That's the thing about the class of 2020, and especially about Bogota students. We're adaptable. Negativity comes our way, and it may upset us, but then we take it into stride, and we move on. That's the kind of life skill we really need. The ability to, when everything seems to be falling apart, pick up the pieces, dodge the falling sky, and continue to strive for success. That isn't something that can be taught in a classroom. And seeing as we haven't seen one of those in a month, we're definitely doing pretty well. We have grown up in some of the most rapidly changing times, and that has made us quite the unique group of young adults. It is strange to me that most of us are actually adults. It seems like just last week we were putting on yellow shirts for the very first time. However, our middle school days are gone, and many of us can drive and will be able to vote in the upcoming election. Wear your seatbelts. In the insane times that have been our high school years, we have learned to cope with and adapt to things that we never could have imagined. We have lived through active shooter drills, anticipated bomb threats, and now a literal pandemic. Yet still, we smile and we laugh and we joke in the face of things that could actually kill us. Some may call us crazy or foolish, but in my eyes, we are unstoppable. So to the class of 2020, here's to us. Here's to the sporting events we had fun at, even if we didn't win. To intense games in ninth grade history that could be heard on the other side of the building. and the math homework that no one ever understood. Here's to the essays and projects that kept us up all night and the essential knowledge of which water fountains have the best tasting water. Here's to senior lunch privileges that somehow always make a good time. And most of all, here's to the friends we found along the way. We are more than high school graduates. We are strong young adults who are as ready as we will ever be to take on the world. As we go our separate ways, remember these good memories and the many more you've made along the way. Thank you all for pushing through these years alongside me, and I know you will continue to find the good amidst your troubles. So celebrate, we made it. Even if you have to celebrate alone in your bedroom, do it. Be proud of how far you've come and how far you will go. Let's prove to the world what a graduating class of 77 students can do. Thank you.
Thank you, Natalie. The Bogota Junior Senior High School Choir, led by Mrs. Lynch, will now sing the selection called Youth by Shawn Mendes featuring Khalid.
Here I am stuck on this couch, scrolling through my notes. Heart was broken, still not growing, no. Waking up to headlines filled with devastation again. My heart is broken, but I keep going. Pain, but I won't let it turn into hate. No, I won't let it change me. Never lose inside of the one I keep inside. Now I know it, yeah, I know it. You can't take my youth away. The soul of mine will never break. As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away. The soul of mine will never break. As long as I wake up today, you can't take my youth away. You can't take my youth away.
Thank you to the Bogota Junior Senior High School Choir. As I sat down to write this, I thought, how do you even begin? How do you address a class you haven't seen in months? How do you do the magnitude of this pandemic any justice? A class that got shorted, a class that got less than they deserved. And as my kids yelled at me to come help them with their schoolwork for the 100th time, and I try my very best to appreciate the special time with them, I say matter-of-factly, I'll be there in a minute. I'm just waiting for the inspiration to hit. And then it did. To the class of 2020, you entered the world during 9/11, and you leave Bogota Junior Senior High School during a pandemic. But do not let Corona be what defined you. Do not let COVID be what defines the class of 2020. We are all so focused on what we missed, we are forgetting to celebrate and commend what we experienced. For all of you, this is years of hard work. Instead of focusing on just this moment, let's focus on all the moments. I can't help when writing this to think about one particular student in this graduating class. I would say he may have been my first discipline issue as a VP in 2016. He was challenging, complicated, hard-headed, and smart. He had a choice to make as he walked these halls. He had moments, he had paths to choose, and for a while, I wasn't sure which way he would go. But he fought, he changed, he grew, he tripped up every once in a while. But then the moment, he made a choice. He seized that moment, and he began to lead others. I will always remember him for those moments, not for this one that he missed today. So I encourage you to do the same. Remember that moment when you first walked into Bogota Junior Senior High School and couldn't open the lock, no matter how many times we showed you. Or when a quiet student who rarely spoke got up and rapped in the middle of a pep rally with 500 people. Alumni Weekend, the 125th anniversary of Bogota, when our football team won and everyone who was anyone was there to see it. Or when the girls were once again named Group 1 state champs. I remember the moment an impromptu dance-off began at the end of the pep rally and Mr. Kennedy began to salsa. Or when you performed at Radio City Music Hall for the first time. The Geography Bee, where there may or may not have been some controversy over the winner. When you won the NJIC Patriot Division in cross country again. or those buzzer beaters where in the blink of an eye, everyone was on the court and Coach Rock was underneath the celebration? How about the fact that you were the first class ever to have a transition day? Or when your principal, your vice principal, and your superintendent changed again? How about when Miss Misa fell off of Sammy's hoverboard, which apparently was a different time than he fell off the playground and broke his arm? Remember playdate between Bixby and Steen before you became one united class? Week of the Arts, the jazz bands, and the high school cast coming to visit you. Could you ever imagine you would be those kids one day? And when you made us all proud, making sure your voices were heard as you marched to town hall. Open mic nights, teen nights at the Bogota Swim Club, and one of my favorite, Mr. Kennedy hiding in a closet and scaring Brandon. Horatio, the skeleton and the ice fishing team, archiving your stories forever at the Bogota Library, and of course, Nacho Day. This is my point. This ceremony is a moment, but just one. And while you deserved it, you didn't need it to build a lifetime of memories with the class of 2020. You are all made up of these moments. You will forget some, you will add a lot more, but you are exactly who you were built to be. You were born in a very uncertain time and left high school the same way. You have been prepared for whatever life throws at you now. You are tough, you will face battles, you will win, you will lose, but they will all be moments that you will learn. To the class of 2020, this is one of those moments. Congrats. Miss Lisa Coles, board president, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of New Jersey as high school principal, I certify that those candidates for graduation assembled who have completed all of the requirements of the state and local boards of education are thereby eligible to receive their diplomas. It is with great pleasure that I present to you the Bogota Junior Senior High School Class of 2020 and Miss Lisa Coles.
On behalf of the Board of Education, I accept the graduates of the Class of 2020 assembled here before me. In recognition of the completion of your prescribed courses of study and upon the certification of your principal, I direct that all graduates here assembled receive a Bogota Junior Senior High School diploma with all rights and privileges appertaining thereto.
At this point, I usually ask for you to hold your applause until I'm finished calling all names. But this year, applaud away as I present to you the class of 2020.
Joshua Abuzid. Eridani A. Adamus Inoue. Victoria E. Alvarez. Kiara Aruz. Michelle D. Batista Morales. Lead K. Bediman. Matthew Bruger. Carlos G. Cabrera. Sebastian Cabrera. Angelique Caceres. Valeria G. Calderon. Andrew Hazar. Renaud Celestine. Rhea Chatterjee. Deval N. Chimilio. Gabrielle A. Cintron. Julianne M. Corneal. Anthony Dazzi. Stephanie De Armas Dominguez. Brian De La Cruz. Eli De La Torre. Junwei Dong. Jonathan Duque. Omar A. Ebed. Robert E. Fabiancha. Stephen Fernandez Soto. Christina Fischetti. Wesley R. Flores. Fanny Garcia Morales. Camilla Garcia Souza. Carlos D. Garcia Duarte. Justin R. Gahey. Andy Guzman De Armas. Natalie C. Hardwick. Harrison E. Herbuns. Selene Jimenez. Sammy Kanawi. Joseph A. Lechuga. Ariana Leon. Griselis Lopez. Amanda Macias.
Alicia E. Maldonado.
Sophia G. Marquez. Giselle Marte. Deborah Martinez. Sebastian Martinez. Nylene Mateo. Christopher Melly. Yael Michelle. Shoret Muhammad. Brandon Coach Montalvo. John Mora. Naomi L. Fuentes. James Mullins. Matthew Mullins. Carly Nunez. Ashling O'Hagan. Stephen M. Papastefano. Lara Pena. Devin G. Ramos. Richard Rodriguez. Olivia P. Rosado. Miguel Rosario. Brian Rubiera. Deborah M. Sands. Joshua Scardavaglione. Kenza Sebi Telemasani. Kashdeep Singh. Markel Singleton. Camilla Sosa. Mia Z. Sumaya. Katie Tobin. Christopher Tomlinson. Eliezer J. Ventura. Jacob D. Wedding. Michael Zayas Bazan.
We now approach the more somber part of our ceremony, one that is filled with tradition, with the reciting of the Afebic Oath and the singing of the Alma Mater. Please enjoy as some of our seniors lead the graduates to recite the oath, the traditional oath of graduates across our country, followed by our co-presidents presenting the Class of 2020 senior gift.
With gratitude to my school, with pride in my community, and with devotion to my country,
I pledge as a graduate to cherish the traditions of Bogota Junior Senior High School, as a citizen to work both alone and with many to improve my community.
And as an American, to obey my country's laws and to support and defend its constitution.
From the graduating class of 2020, Carly and I, as your presidents, would like to present the gift to Bogota High School.
This year's gift is going to be a bench for the back courtyard engraved with the quote, "Even through the darkness, they found light." It's going to be under this year's mural, which is also special because it's going to be the first and only one outside of the school.
Of course, the year did not end on such a great note, but we got to do what we have to do to make the best of it.
Thank you to our class officers and the class of 2020. I would now ask everyone to listen and feel free to sing along as Gabrielle Cintron leads the class in the singing of the Alma Mater, written by Sheik Eastwood, class of 32.
In future years when life's a play and we are gray, let come what may, our thoughts revert to the days of old, where we staked our all on the purple and gold. There's a castle built on knowledge, the place where friends are made. It's a stepping stone to college, where our path of life is laid. Although the world we travel round, although the end is nigh, we'll not forget the joy we found at our dear Bogota High.
Our class presidents will now lead the class in their last official act as senior class presidents, and that is to move the tassels to the position of graduate, which is to the left. And I would like to offer my sincere congrats to the class of 2020, and thank you all for sharing in this unprecedented special occasion.
Class of 2020, today we bring our high school journey to an end so we can begin our next adventure.
Now move your tassel to the left, symbolizing we're officially graduates.
I'll say, I did. where I lived.